Our next guest makes people laugh out loud all over the country. Please welcome Aries Spears. How
Yo,
are you?
Yo, how you doing?
Good to see you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Okay, so I just read that you've been doing stand-up since you were 14 years old.
Yeah.
Do you remember the moment when you made someone laugh and you were like, ah, I like this?
Yeah, when I kept getting suspended from school.
Really?
Yeah, I took the
class clown.
The emphasis off the teacher and put it on myself. And when I was getting the responses that I wanted, I was like, okay, I might be on to something.
Right. Yeah. And so what'd you get suspended for?
Just, you know, doing things I shouldn't have been doing. You know, I grew up watching so much comedy from Richard Pryor, Red Fox, George Carlin, Murphy.
Right.
That I didn't want to come out and do kiddie stuff. I didn't want to be, hey, look at this kid being kiddie.
Oh, right.
You know, I always went for the jugular. You know, I just watching those guys and how edgy they were, and they were truth tellers. So that's always just kind of been my format.
It worked though, because even at a young age, you booked Apollo at the theater, and
where they boo you.
They do.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, black people's patience level is short. We go into a club, we done bought wings. You gotta be funny.
Right, right.
You know, white people a little bit more tolerant.
You didn't get booed, did you? No.
No, no, yeah. I actually got a standing ovation.
There you go.
So, you know, I kind of felt like I was on to something, you know?
You know, I was reading research last night, and they have a list of his impressions that he could do. I'm not kidding. I was scrolling through on my phone.
You now, some of that, if it's Wikipedia, I was on Mad TV for 8 years, and at one point it was just me and Deborah as the only black cast members. So sometimes I played roles just to fill the quota.
Right.
It wasn't like I could do the impression. They just went, we need a black woman now.
That's pretty good right
so
there,
it
though.
It was what it was, yeah.
Like, that's pretty good. Okay, can you do an impression
for
us? Who do you want to do?
Shaq's always fun.
Okay, let's do Shaq. I love Shaq.
Shaq is here.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Right, me and
ask,
Shaq.
Yeah.
Right. Hi, Shaq, how are you?
I'm good.
I see you doing a lot of commercials these days.
You know, I played a long time in basketball. It's one of my dominant sets. I have a lot of fun doing the commercials. Y'all know all my commercials, but I've always been a Renaissance man.
Wait.
Okay.
The eyes.
That hurts. Yeah.
Has Shaq seen this?
Hurts.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
He loves it. I did the first Shaq's All-Star Comedy Jam.
Okay.
D-Ray Davis, Kevin Hart, Cedric, and Tommy Davidson. And I messed with Shaq in the crowd. Every time he sees me, he acts as though he's never told me this, but he always goes, make fun of me. Dude, you tell me to do that every single time.
Do Jay-Z.
Oh, Jay-Z, question.
Okay, Jay-Z, how is it going with the twins, the new twins?
It's real good. You know, I got Blue Ivy, you know, and I got my another son, so, you know, it's all good. You know, me and Beyonce recently went to Africa for vacation. She loved it, so I'm going to buy it. I'm going to be the first black man to own black men. It's your boy.
Do you ever lose friends because of your material on stage?
No, because I only got two friends in life.
Right.
I learned a long time ago, new friends mean new BS.
Right.
So I got the people that grew up with me, that know me. I'm too old to figure you out.
So, you know, the thing I always wonder is, you know, you see a lot of people like Jay Leno, and they continue to do the comedy circuit even after they've made it. Does that keep you friends? What?
It pays the bills.
Does it? Okay.
I mean, I do have love for it, but, you know, some guys are gym rats, like Chris Rock. No matter how big he gets, he's a gym rat. He stays in the comedy clubs. And some dudes, once they reach a certain level, they go, hey, I don't want to do this no more. It's just too much work.
Right, hard. Right.
Yeah.
So you're originally from New York,
yes.
But you like LA, I read, tell me if this is true, because you like the weather and the women.
Well, there's one more thing in there.
What's that?
Women, the weather, and the weed.
WWW.
You can't beat it, baby. Yeah. You know, I know Snoop Dogg. We have a good time.
Somebody just applauded.
Yeah.
Golf clap.
You are the best. Okay, so if you guys want to catch Aries, he's going to be at the Irvine Improv Thursday through Sunday. For tickets, go to irvine.improv.com. You are so great.
Thank you. And that Kushner thing, don't we kind of miss Barack and Michelle a little bit? And a good portion of white America loved Barack because he was wholesome, clean, family oriented. He was like Cosby before the rapes.
Oh, Aries.
Okay.
You guys, anything?
How many dates do you do a year?
I work all year round. I don't take a break. Yeah.
You're on the road.
I'm on the road constantly.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
The gas storage.